Programming is brought to you in part by Sonoma Market, Glen Ellen Village Market, Body Best Collision Center, Larbrae Automotive, Myers Financial, Tina Schoen, Broker Associate, Sotheby's, buywine.com, and The Cottage Inn and Spa, located at 310 First Street East in Sonoma, a block from Sonoma's quaint town square. Step into the Cottage Inn and Spa and be transformed by its peaceful setting. For more information, you can call 707-996-0719, or you can visit their website at cottageinnandspa.com.
Hello, I'm Rick Love for Sonoma Valley Television at the Sonoma International Film Festival. As part of our filmmaker interview series, I have with me writer-director Peter McEvilley and producer Howard Sapper, who have brought the short film Dogumentary, with a G, to the festival as part of our shorts program. It's about a rescue dog named Barrett who creates abstract expressionist paintings, and I wouldn't have believed it. I'm picturing paws covered in paint and all of that until I actually saw your film and saw how this dog works. How did the dog's owner come up with this idea to create this painter and his pet and friend?
Well, the dogs are actually, the dog is one of the Olathe dogs, which they're an act, and they won America's Got Talent in 2012. So I actually came up with the concept. I'm doing four films sponsored by Halo purely for pets. And so the idea was, I wanted to figure out, could I get the dog to actually create art? So I also do art as a hobby in my garage after the kids go to bed. It's a lot of Jackson Pollock type splattering paint. And I was trying to think of cool ways to get the dog involved, and, you know, just to see how much I could get the dog, like, is the dog aware, you know? So that was the idea. And so I sort of came up with the idea, and then I told the owner, or the trainer, Richard, you know, what I wanted the dog to do, and he's just amazing. I mean, we put the empty cups first, he showed the dog how to do it, and the dog just did it.
On the first time?
Well, you know, pretty much, you know, ideally the dog would knock all five over in a row, and most times, yeah, it seemed to know what it was doing, and after doing it a few times, actually started to clearly enjoy doing it. Like, it was excited to, kind of like you throw a dog a frisbee and it catches it, it brings it back and says, hey, let's do that again. I enjoyed it, right? So it was the same thing. It's like, okay, oh, he sees what, or she sees what she needs to do, and she was excited to do it, and then she would sort of sit next to the painting. You know, we take pictures. She seemed to be proud of the
That's
the
one
painting.
Of my favorite shots in your film, is the dog sitting there when you're in the park there. It's like pride of ownership.
Yeah, exactly. So that was really the idea, is to see, you know, how much we could get the dog involved, and, you know, can the dog really understand what it's doing? So, yeah, you can watch the film and get a sense. I don't know. I think the dog did. So.
Mm-hmm. Well, it certainly seemed like it. So Barrett is, what's the dog's actual name? Is that the character is Barrett?
The dog is named Lily.
Lily.
so Lily is playing Barrett.
Okay.
It's actually the film combines, you know, real things like the dog actually making the paintings, and then of course there's a voiceover mm-hmm. that's just all, you know, it's for fun. It was inspired by, there's a great documentary about Jackson Pollock in his, you know, how he works, and also there's one about Philip Glass I saw, just, you know, like a day in the life of the artist. They sort of follow him around. Mm-hmm. Here he is making pizza, here he is going to his studio. So I wanted to do something like that, like, what would it be like, a dog artist, you know, a day in the life.
Well, and one of the things that stands out is it's very fun, it's very light-hearted, yet you create this artwork that is then sold and benefits animal shelters around the country.
Yeah, we're thrilled because we just found out that all 12 of the paintings sold.
I saw them, and they were, you were getting good prices on those. Every single one was over minimum bid.
Yeah.
The paintings were on easels out in front of the Sebastiani for their screening today.
Yeah, we could not be happier with it. It's Nancy over at Pets Lifeline helped us. Howard, of course, was very, you know, he's, you know, helped get it all organized, and all the proceeds benefit the local shelter. So we may do more things like this where we play the film, partner with like galleries in various cities, put some paintings up, buy the dog, play the film, people can come meet the dog,
make some money,
bid on the paintings, and that would benefit local rescues, like, you know, partner with a local rescue who might help promote it. So this was sort of the first test, and it just went really well. We're thrilled.
We'll be in Texas in May, and there are some galleries down there that are hoping that we have more paintings ready since all of these sold, because the rescue community is really moved by Peter's work in general, mm-hmm. and also by the fact that the Lilia Latte has been involved with the family that's also being national spokesperson for animal rescue.
So Howard, when you got the call from Peter saying, so I want to do this movie about a dog painter, mm-hmm. you've worked with him for 6 films now, so was it just like, yeah, let's go, or was it like, I need some more convincing on this one?
I actually didn't need any convincing, because there was 2 things that I was totally sure of. One is that most of Peter's creative ideas, he's one of those few people that are right and left brained, so I know that he had thought it through very well, and that there was a way to get there, and I have incredible respect for Richard Alate, who I think is probably at this point the world's greatest dog trainer.
Certainly one of the most famous, the first name that you would think of in that category.
And so Peter had asked Richard to do a very difficult task in his first film, Le Sauvetage, and we were blown away that within 3 minutes of Spanish dog whispering, the dog was able to do it. So we had a sense of confidence that with Peter's vision and Richard's ability to actualize, that we had a fairly good chance. But what we didn't realize is how much fun Lily was going to be having and this great sense of satisfaction when the paintings were complete.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's amazing to see. She really does look like she's standing pride there with her artwork behind her, and people are taking, it's like a red carpet moment right there. Yeah. The star, Lily Olate. The film is Dogumentary. Thank you very much for writer, director Peter McEvilley and producer Howard Sapper for coming and talking to us today. I'm Rick Love for Sonoma Valley Television at the Sonoma International Film Festival. And this is our filmmaker interview series.